Ladies and gentlemen, it's Dave Neal here, stand-up comic host of Bachelor Nation News, and we have a Bachelor adjacent story. As you know, we've been following Bachelor Clayton Echard in his pursuits of truth and justice and the collateral damage that has been literally ripped across Scottsdale, Arizona. A podcast studio has, I guess, received some complaints over shoddy workmanship due to the lady who was accused, Clayton Echard, Laura Owens, due to her not enjoying the final product. Because of that, we've got the studio here to share their side of the story and bring back the good word of the PS Creative Studios. It's their founder, Layla Adnani. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You know, every video I make, it's so hard. I try to give the whole story to intro the video, but we've been doing this for over a year now. How did you find out about the Clayton Echard scandal? Was it after hosting the lady?
Yeah. Oh my gosh. And we work and live in Scottsdale, so it's amazing that I'd never heard of this before, but I admittedly am not part of Bachelor Nation. So I know that tons of ex-bachelors live here in Scottsdale, but I had no idea this whole, microcosm of things going on. When they came in to use our space, we get tons of walk-in bookings, so that's not anything unusual. You pay, we reserve your time, you show up, you record. The initial red flag, though, was the imagery that they wanted portrayed on the TV during their interview, right? And we've had wild backdrops on TVs before, but it had the Justice for Clayton name written in this backdrop. And so that led during the interview to my team Googling, like, what the heck is all this? I myself wasn't even in town. I was in Houston with clients. And so I'm finding out about this entire saga after the fact of what was going on. And then it really erupted that next day when we got tagged on Instagram.
Yeah, I've recorded at plenty of podcast studios, very professional setup. When someone comes in, you throw their logo on the screen, couple $100 an hour, whatever, that you have a sound technician there, no big deal. I mean, who's going to screen everybody that comes in? And to be quite honest, I wouldn't judge you guys for hosting their podcast, because I've been one to say, let them continue to share their side of the story. It's so bizarre and so full of lies that all we've done on our side is take everything they're saying and correct the narrative with the truth. We've shared it for a year. I don't know how far you've dug into me. I've been threatened with an $85+ million defamation lawsuit over this. I mean, silly talk. Have you joined the club being threatened with defamation?
That was part of her Better Business Bureau complaint and her Arizona Attorney General complaint, was that we communicated with the Justice for Clayton Instagram, which is how we were alerted that she was tied to our studio. And then, the whole thing really started to snowball and unfold. And like I said, we don't Google everybody before they come in. So we didn't really know what the ramifications of all this would be. But yeah, that was part of the complaints that she filed. And the whole basis of these complaints was that the audio, we didn't receive our files, which we have audio of her waiting, getting the files on her hard drive and leaving. And at our studio.
You're saying you handed her you dumped her the footage in person.
In person, and we have audio of my technician doing that. He recorded the entire interaction so that nobody could come back and say, hey, I didn't get my files.
Oopsie. So yeah, because she's not an idiot when it comes to, like, she's had multiple faux pregnancy scandals and restraining orders and this and that. And every single one, she evolves a little bit and gets smarter and smarter. So I wonder if she realized that because you didn't digitally give it to her, there wouldn't be any metadata attached to her receiving that. But you're saying, no, you recorded old school audio. The irony of a podcast studio rolling the audio to make sure that their bases are covered is so funny.
Well, so fast forward, she files these complaints, and then I email and I say, here's your Dropbox link. If this is about you not getting your files, here's the proof, right? Because I wanted the paper trail at that point, not just the audio of us making sure that, hey, we've given you these files. And apologies, sent that over. And in our booking, we don't have a contract. So it's literally you pay. If you don't show up, we don't refund you. It's non-refundable time. If you show up, great. We give you your files and you're on your way. We either give them to you in person or we put them on Dropbox. In this case, we did both. We typically don't do both, but no big deal. I wanted this to go away. We didn't want to be involved in all of this. But now it's turned into an opportunity for her to defame my business, to defame our credibility, and to bully us. And that's really kind of seems like the entire agenda here all along. And that's why I'm finally stepping up and speaking out, because enough is enough. We haven't done anything wrong. You paid for something, you received it. Leave us alone.
Yeah. And look, I mean, it's like you're a podcast studio. You don't want even one review saying the audio was the issue. You know, it's like you, it's not rocket science. You had a sound technician there. You can listen to it. It's good. Now, so you guys shared on your Instagram, the female and the male, the two guys in the room, Laura and her attorney, you shared both their versions of the audio. She tried to share through her attorney the audio from the camera, which is always going to come
back. Always crap, right? If you go to a podcast studio, this is for everybody listening, watching, and they give you audio from the camera, your audio is going to be absolute shit. And it's a crappy studio. So I hope you didn't pay for that time. Anyone who's doing things at the level that we're doing them should have separate audio files that has been mastered, recorded, and, you know, the level set to those guests. Everybody speaks at different levels. There's different reverb, you know, directionally. If I'm back here, if I'm up here, a lot of things go into having good sound. Your camera is going to have the worst sound. So if you take the camera files and then try and claim that that was your audio file, no, you just didn't edit and put these two things together.
And it's like, yeah, it's like when you listen to a documentary and you'll have the subject answer a question, and then off in the distance, they'll play like the faint audio of the producer asking the questions. They're never mic'd up. But in a podcast setup, everyone's mic'd up. You guys proved that you had the pro audio. And Laura can't really use ignorance as a defense here, because she's had a podcast for several years. She's worked in these studio setups, and she used Adobe Acrobat to create medical fraud when she tried to convince me she was pregnant. So she knows her way around Adobe. She clearly has all of the tools and resources, and her lawyer can't be this dumb to think that that was the audio that you guys gave them. I mean, do you believe, like, can you even believe you're somehow, you know, stuck in or like collateral damage to this whole like,
It's crazy. And literally, I thought it was going away, right? We put our statement out. Justice for Clayton was like, everybody leave the studio alone. They want nothing to do with this. Things really died down. And we went a week and we're like, okay, good. This is over with. Hallelujah. And then the Better Business Bureau complaint comes in, and the Arizona Attorney General complaint comes in. And then I send her the files via Dropbox. And I was like, leave us alone. You got to drop this. Better Business Bureau has dropped it. We're waiting on the Attorney General. But I would not release the clips of the audio until they're defaming us on Twitter, saying that it was unusable and saying that our quality of work is terrible. First off, our raw audio files are excellent. And you didn't pay for editing, right? If you wanted the complete video and audio synced together, we could easily do that. But also, if you spend 4 minutes on Google, you can figure out how to layer in your audio with your video. So this is just another attention-seeking endeavor, in my opinion, and another way for her to bully somebody who, you know, does not support all the drama that surrounds her. And that's all this really feels like.
So you're in Texas when this goes down. Do you call your team and go, hey, what did you guys do? Like, how did you get caught up on all of this? Did you YouTube and see my channel? Like walk me through catching up in real time to this whole story and how, you know, how it kind of started.
So I'm in Texas and I don't manage our social media. We have someone who does that. And she texts me and she's like, SOS, sends me a screenshot of the Justice for Clayton post that has a picture of said female with one of our custom mugs that says PS Studios in it. And I was like, oh no, now this whole scandal is going to get linked back to us. And we're getting all of these DMs of people saying, hey, I don't know why you would let her in. This is a really bad move. You know, they're kind of coming after us as if we condone everything that she stands for. And I was like, listen, we want nothing to do with it. That's where I'm coming in and I'm responding. And I'm in the middle of meetings in Texas with some of our largest clients and I'm freaking out. I'm like, team, handle this. Like, you guys got this handled. Like, keep me posted, whatever. Finally, I get out of those and I go online and then I see your stuff. And then I'm looking at all these DMs and I'm catching up to the conversations that have been going on behind the scenes. I did put out that statement that was me saying, please, you know, leave us out of this. We want nothing to do with it. And then that's what said female wants to claim is defaming to her, is that we said we want nothing to do with her. Even though, like I said, we didn't even name who she was. if you knew the scandal, then you knew who we are referring to. But beyond that, we're not here to drag her through the mud. But it feels like that's exactly what she's trying to do to us. But fast forward, our entire team, you know, dug into trying to understand what is all of this. And then I get a DM from Ashley, who's married to Greg. And Ashley and I know each other through being in the community. We've done events together. She's great. And I was like, I had no idea the magnitude of all this. She's like, I'm so sorry that you're now, you know, stuck in this web of things as well. It's been a nightmare for us for the past couple of years. And I mean, just that's kind of how it snowballed.
So just for our audience here, when you say Ash and Greg, you mean Greg Gillespie, who we've referred to as victim two, a man who she has an active restraining order against. She also tried to get a restraining order, or at least a cease and desist, sent to Ashley's business several years ago, which we've received. Ashley is actually, I think I can say this with confidence, the bad bitch who linked Greg up to Clayton. Ashley was the one who says she was the one who saw this go down, because for the first, you know, at 10 months or so, we referred to her as Jane Doe because I didn't want to deal with any lawsuits or whatever. And even with that said, I was still being threatened. You know, she called the FBI on me and all these crazy things, accused me of revenge porn and what, just batshit crazy things. But the thing is, for people that aren't caught up on the show, you might go, oh, geez, Dave, what the hell did you do? And I'm sure with your audience, you know, they don't want, you know, when people book your studio, they don't want drama. They want to know you're going to make a good product for them, you know? So there really is no benefit for you to be caught up with this in any way whatsoever. But what a small world it is that, you know, one of the victims of all of this.
I mean, and that's the thing with Scottsdale, the fact that none of us had ever heard of it before is astounding, because it is such a small bubble that we live in here. But like you said, we don't want to be part of anybody's drama, not just these two who walked in, but literally anybody. We're here to run a business. We're here to make money, and we're here to do a good job at what we do. And that's not to be, you know, embroiled in any of this kind of stuff. So it's been a huge distraction, I will say that. And like I said, I'm only speaking out about it now because you're trying to defame my business with Better Business Bureau reviews, which are visible online, and Arizona Attorney General complaints. That's crazy. I have to stand up. And then you're going to say things on Twitter, which is a very public place to say things. Clearly, the studio is my studio. Like, I'm here to set those records straight. So,
well, we appreciate that. Now, have you looked into, not that you would do this, but have you looked into releasing the episode? Legally speaking, can you release their podcast episode yourself?
Like, since there's no contract in place for walk-ins, there's nothing that says, hey, this is, you own this IP or I own this IP. I feel like it's a little bit of a gray area. Could I? Maybe. But to be honest with you, and I told Lauren this last night, I haven't even watched it. I don't want to sit there for 2 hours and continue to waste more time, like, learning what, like, there's really nothing positive that can come of that. So on my official stance on that is I will not release something of that nature because I don't see the point of adding more fuel to the fire. However, their excuse of we can't release it because the audio is bad is simply just an excuse.
And to be quite honest, even as now, I wouldn't even call that audio bad, but your camera audio, even if that's all they had, I mean, if there was if that audio was needed in a court or documentary, that's perfectly serviceable audio. Like, it's just not great audio. It's not it wasn't the pro audio that you had. So that whole excuse by them, it's like, if it was worth sharing, they would share it.
I literally can screen share. I don't even know if I can do that on this app, but I could show you the files that she received. Video files are in one folder. Audio files are in another folder. It could not be more clear that these are two separate sets of files.
You'd have to be a true idiot. And this is coming from me because I only learned about about audio and tech by creating my own podcast, which she has done. So there's no way around this. There's no excuse for them. She was trying to, and again, I don't know why they would do that, knowing you could call their bluff. Again, maybe she thought because she received the audio, the hard drive in person, maybe that was how she thought she could get away with some sort of deniability that you actually sent her the audio files. Which again, it's not important. What's important is at any point in time, if say, and again, this didn't happen, but say you didn't send her the audio files, an easy email exchange would get her the audio files. Like, this happens in business where you go, oh, sorry, you sent me the wrong graphic. Could you, and you boop, 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 you know, you're just, that's how it works. So she paid in advance. I think was she trying to cancel her order through her credit system? Like, is this going to affect you guys at all financially?
She wants a refund, and that's her entire basis for the Arizona Attorney General complaint, as well as the Better Business Bureau complaint, to which I said, you paid for a service, you received that service. There's proof that you've received that service, not only via the audio of my producer recording, giving the files to her on her hard drive, but also the email chain of sending the Dropbox link as well. So we did our end of the bargain. I'm not refunding you for that, especially after all the drama and chaos you've caused. It's not even about the money for us. It's really just about the fact that, no, I'm not giving you something for free, especially after you continue to sit here and defame me and cause chaos amongst my office. Better Business Bureau complaints. I mean, get out of here.
Yeah, I mean, so she's done this. She's complained to the agencies on Clayton's behalf. This guy Sean, who is a contractor, she actually got him. She actually was able to garnish his wages up to $100,000 because she hired this contractor to build some barn or something, and she kept on changing what she wanted done. And in the end, they ruled in her favor. And this was a guy who almost had his new company, upended. And he's a Native American contractor in Scottsdale. And it seems as though she's gone after in some companies, newer type companies, and maybe trying to prey on their inexperience. But you guys have been around for a while, though. Like, what is this? Podcasting studios, that's not all you guys do, right? Like, no. Is this just a fraction? Did you get into this game more recently?
So we have two sides of the business. We've been in business for 14 years, started in Washington, D.C., really more on the creative agency and live event digital marketing side. And then I moved out to Arizona in 2018. We opened up our podcast studio, the first location, in 2020 during the pandemic, because we felt the new wave of media will be podcasting. And a lot of other businesses had kind of dried up because, you know, people weren't going to events. Marketing was kind of dead because nobody could really do much during COVID. Fast forward now, it's almost 2025. We've gotten very good at the game. We've got podcast clients that we produce their entire show. All they do is come in, they record, we handle everything else, all the publishing, all the editing, all the clips, all their social media. And then we've got a lot of people who are traveling. They need a studio. They find us online. They book their studio time, just like those two did. They get their files, they leave, and they're on their way. Like, it's a simple, you know, transaction. The walk-in business is a small portion of our business, but, you know, that it's the podcasting is a sliver of what we do, and the rest is, you know, digital.
Yeah, so I saw this on one of the Instagram accounts. They were offering free services to the victims. Was that something that the Justice Clayton account was offering, or you guys?
So we said, if anybody wants to be able to share their side of the story and they're local in Scottsdale, we're willing to have them come into our studio to be able to professionally do that.
I think that's hilarious. When I'm in Scottsdale, I am proudly going to pay you guys to use your studio. I like to, you know, compensate people for their time. That's what most humans do. But, well, hopefully it doesn't go any further. Will you have any updates with the Better Business Bureau?
Better Business Bureau dropped it. They said, you know, you're not in the wrong, and we're done wasting our time with this, fortunately. And then Arizona Attorney General, I have not checked that email account yet today, but I'm assuming the same thing will probably transpire there. And if it doesn't, then I'm happy to escalate it. I do have a full legal team. I just have not engaged them in this because it's ridiculous. And my lawyer would be like, did you give them the files they paid for? I sure did. Well, then we really don't have a case here. Besides, if I wanted to go after her for now defaming us on Twitter, which, to be honest, I just don't want to have to continue down this rabbit hole.
Yeah. And you know what? She's already owes Clayton $150,000. So she might be tight on cash when this is all said and done. Now, my last question, when you did find out that there was a, like, sort of a support group online for the victims here, how did that, did you initially feel like, you know, cause no one likes to be threatened with lawsuits. There is a weird kind of feeling in your gut when you build a business, you're the founder, you've got all of this equity and time and emotion into it. What was it like to find this community online? Did that provide you some reassurance knowing you had, like, people backing you?
A little bit, but at the end of the day, it's still our battle that we have to fight, right? It's nice to get those supportive messages for sure. And it's nice to have people who are like, hey, guess what? We're not going to let, like, these people defame you. But still, it's like, it's still really frustrating, I guess is the best way of putting it. But they, most people have been very, very kind. And the number one thing people could do is go leave us a great Google review, because those are the reviews that count. I don't think anybody looks at our Better Business Bureau profile, but
yeah, what a boomer thing to do. That's so old school. It's like Google, Yelp. I mean, that's great. And also, because, you know, this happened with Clayton, where you don't know the gigs you'll lose out on. And you don't know if someone Googles you and they see that tweet versus someone else's and they just decide to go with someone else. So it can be a real challenge. So hopefully we just nip this in the bud and you guys are, you know, able to have a, you know, not, you know, think about it again. But I want to thank you so much for taking the time to explain the story. I think it's important for us as we cover this. Like, I've been labeled a psycho for making hundreds of videos on this, but, you know, having been threatened with $100 million lawsuits, I think it's important that I make sure every story is told, just so everybody is clear who's the good guy and who's the bad guy here. I think that's
100%. And I was telling Lauren last night, I go, the problem is that I think this person thrives on the attention, right? If nobody's talking about her, she needs to go do something like come into a studio and then pretend she didn't get the files or that they weren't good enough so that she's relevant again and people are talking about her again. I think that's what gives her a sense of purpose and excitement. And it's a double-edged sword, because here we are. I've never in a million years thought I would be talking about anything related to Bachelor Nation on podcasts that millions of people are watching. And I never thought my business would be embroiled in any of this kind of stuff, but this is what she thrives on. And so she'll continue to cause problems for small businesses like myself. And the important part is being able to expose, talk about that, and for people to have resources to understand the right side and the wrong side of what these people are doing. They're literally trying to ruin small businesses and people's livelihoods.
Yeah. Well, sunlight's the greatest disinfectant. So here we are shining some light on it. Come back anytime if you have any updates. I appreciate you taking the time to chat with us.
Awesome, Dave. Good to meet you.